All right, we are live. So, hey guys, it's Corey with the Mills team at Keller Williams Realty, and I'm here with Taylor Vinoy, and who just had a birthday yesterday. So if you didn't wish her a birthday yesterday, hop down in the comments section and go ahead and wish her a birthday happy birthday right now. She said that all she wanted for her birthday was some referrals for new clients.
Exactly.
So not Taylor.
Taylor, though, make sure it's to Taylor.
Yeah, referrals to Taylor for buyers and sellers. So what Taylor and I are going to be talking about today is we're going to go over some information of what we have seen in the North Texas real estate market in the month of July. So Taylor, I'm going to share my screen real quick. Let me minimize this. All right. I'm going to share my screen so we can go over these numbers. So Taylor, just talk to us a little bit about what we've seen in the month of July in terms of active listings and transactions and all that stuff and kind of what you're seeing out there in the marketplace. And we'll just start off with Grayson County and we'll go through some other markets that we cover.
Okay, so we talked about it last month, kind of the trends we were seeing, and that's just continuing to grow. It's actually kind of getting a little stronger with that trend. So if you look at this housing report here for Grayson County, the median sales price is 213. So that's actually up 3.9% from last year. So we are seeing home prices increase a little bit. If you look at active listings, you'll see they're down 23.7%. So that's huge, meaning we just have very limited inventory right now. And then if you hop over to closed sales, you'll see where it's up 19.1%. So again, we're seeing that same increase from last month's housing report where listings are going down, but closings are also going up at the same time. So what that means is we have a low inventory. We have tons of buyers right now. Interest rates are historically low. I've had people lock in 2.6, 2.75 just this week. So they're actually able to purchase more than they ever have before because of those interest rates. But on the other end, listings are down. So it's making it a very competitive seller's market right now, just because we do have that limited inventory.
Okay. And one thing I want to point out too, you know, people ask what the market's doing, and different price points kind of tell a different story. Mm-hmm. So where we're seeing the most activity is in this, you know, especially under 200,000, but even, you know, 100 to 300,000 is where a majority of our sales, and, you know, it kind of goes along with the median sales price, but this is where the most activity is taking place in our market and where it can be very competitive. So if you're looking to buy in that price point or sell, this kind of gives you some insight on what's going on. So if we look at Cook County, which is also an area we cover, Taylor, talk about what we're seeing over there as well. And it's kind of the same
thing in Cook County. It's actually a little bit crazier though. So sales price is up to 211. So it's up 5.5% from last year. Mm-hmm. Active listings are down 30.9%, but closed sales are up 38.5%. So same trend, just a little bit stronger over in Cook County. Same thing, low inventory, but plenty of ready, willing, and able buyers out there that are looking to buy. So my advice for any buyers, I mean, definitely, we've talked about this over and over again. Now more than ever, it's most important to get pre-approved up front, because most of the time when you're going into this market that has very limited inventory, if you're looking at any homes that are priced correctly, you know, especially like we talked about in that price range of anywhere from 100 to 300,000, usually by the time you get there, there is a high possibility that there's already multiple offers on that house. So for sure, get pre-approved beforehand, because what'll happen is if you go and look at a house and you fall in love with it, you know, more than likely you're going to be waiting, you know, anywhere from 1 to 3, even more days on a lender to get you an application in, get you pre-approved, get everything you need. And by then that house is already pending. It's already off the market.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, a lot of buyers, so I tell every buyer that I work with, hey, let's get pre-approved up front. And one of the things that they say is, oh, well, getting financing is not going to be a big deal. Mm-hmm. And I think that they feel like I'm questioning whether they can actually get approved for a loan. And it's never that. Sometimes it's that, but it's most of the times it is knowing that situation of, hey, if you look at this house that we're going to go look at and you fall in love with it, and you don't have a pre-approval letter ready to go to write an offer, you're not going to get your offer accepted. Sellers will not entertain an offer without a pre-approval letter. So you absolutely hit the nail on the head. One other thing, just, and this is kind of the same story among all these markets that we cover, when you look at months of inventory, and of course all these numbers point to that, but 2.9 months of inventory versus 5.4 this time last year. And so whenever you're looking at months of inventory, they say that 6 months is a balanced market. Anything less than 6 months is considered a seller's market, and anything more is considered a buyer's market. So this gives you some insight that it is, you know, if you're out there thinking about selling your home and you're curious what the market's doing, you know, this is definitely gives you some insight on that. And if you're thinking about listing, I highly recommend that you either reach out to Taylor or reach out to myself and talk about what that looks like for you. And we'd love to help you out with that. So whenever you look at the Sherman numbers, once again, Taylor, kind of go over some of this and what we're seeing.
So same thing, sales price is constantly increasing. Active listings are down 27.2% and closed sales are up 3.9%. Same thing that you just kind of touched on, that months on inventory is 2.7. So that's well, obviously, below the balance market of six. So same trends. I mean, everywhere in this area we're looking at, it's the same story. Same thing with Denison. Median sales price is up 4.7%. Active listings down 7.6%. And closed sales are up 36.6%. So that's a pretty drastic jump up from last year's numbers in the month of July.
Yeah. And then just to give you guys some insight on here in August, you know, within the past 7 days, this is what we've seen.
So if you see just from this past week in August, we've had 73 new listings. We've had 68 homes go over to pending. And then if you look, you can see closed. Sold as well, which was 51. So we do have some newer listings, but you can kind of tell by those numbers, just as quickly as they're being listed, those same amount of homes are going under contract and being sold. So as quickly as they're coming on the market, they're moving. And kind of one more thing I want to point out as well, as a buyer in this market right now, because it is such a strong seller's market and inventory is so low, a lot of people question if they need an agent or not, or if it's beneficial to them. And we've pointed this out and said it many times before, but as a buyer, you do not pay anything to use a buyer's agent. And it's, so it's 100% in your favor to use an agent, because like I kind of mentioned before earlier as well, sometimes when you get to these homes, there's already multiple offers on there. And you really need to be able to go in with a strong, aggressive offer. So it is important now more than ever to have an agent kind of backing you up and guiding you through the whole process to kind of help you, you know, decipher what is a strong offer and what offer can I submit that's going to, you know, let me win out over these five other people that are putting in an offer at the same time right now.
Right, exactly. And sometimes, believe it or not, the highest sales price is not what gets an offer accepted.
Yeah.
There's so many different terms in a contract and different negotiating points that can really appeal to a seller. Mm-hmm. And having an agent like Taylor or like myself who understands, okay, what's most important to this seller and how do we get this offer accepted? That's where it really comes into play. And that's why now more than ever, who you work with is extremely important. So anyways, I think that's about all we have to share with you guys. If you have any specific questions on what your home could sell for, or if you're looking to buy a house, first off, if you're looking to buy a house, talk to a lender. Second, talk to Taylor or talk to myself. We'd love to help you guys out. If y'all have any questions, like I said, feel free to reach out. Other than that, you guys have a great day and we will talk to you soon.